Got a cool Roy Orbison song for you. Roy Orbison, Traveling Wilburys, that whole thing. I didn't know who these guys were until I saw the Tom Petty documentary, Running Down a Dream. It's like 4 hours long, but it's worth it. It's a really cool, really cool documentary of the whole story of all those guys. All right, so good song for rhythm. We're going to be starting out on an A, bar 2-2-2 on the DGB, open A, mute the low E with your thumb so you can really get after it. All right, so we're just going to start out. Okay, you're going to be doing these 16th notes. All right. And when you switch chords, kind of give it an open string. Switch from G to the D. Keep your ring finger on the third fret on the B for that transition. All right, so you got. All right, so in between you got in the changes. So he's going to do that three times or so, and then the change, he's going to go to E. All right, and then he's going to go to a G and play the G like your standard G chord. 3-2, open, G. Don't play this one. Play that one. You can hear he's got the open B in there. All right, so. Into the next part, you're gonna go A, F sharp minor, bar 2, 4-4 on the A and D. And he's kind of got this rhythm going, kind of follows the drums a little bit. The drums will change and go. So you can kind of get. Kind of rhythm. Just follow along to the drums and you'll feel it as soon as you play along to the song. Okay, then we're going to go to C sharp minor. You got 4, 6, 6, 5. So just bar 4. Play like an A minor shape. All right, and in between, you don't really want to let off the chords if you don't have to, so you get kind of like this slide effect. Kind of sliding in. Okay, so that's, and now we're going to get into the chorus of anything you want, you got it. Trick here. When you're going, we're gonna go from A up to the C sharp 7 chord. Okay? And when you do that, here's what you want to be thinking. Okay, you're already barring the D, G, and B, right? So you want to go ahead and get ready for that chord, and you want to put your ring and pinky finger on the D and B and be able to slide in almost like you're already on that chord. So when you hit this A, you're sliding, so you're, instead of going here and then trying to land on it, you can do that. I just think it sounds cool if you go like a. See what I'm saying? Instead of playing it straight and going like. nothing wrong with that. I just think it's, you know, again, I just like filling space with everything. So you just kind of go. So it's almost like you're forming a B7 chord right as you're transitioning. And you're just getting ready. Okay, and then if you go to that C sharp 7, you're going to go back to this F sharp minor, bar 2, 4, 4. Then we're going to go to D. Alright. And in between, hit those open strings. So in between each chord change, that's how you keep the rhythm flowing. Okay, then we get into this part. You're just going to drum the A for a second, and then he's going to go. Alright, so he's just going 7 on the A, 5 on the A, 4, 2. Open, 4 on the low E, 2 on the low E, and low E. Alright. And then, what else does it, I think that's all it does. Yeah, he does a cool thing in the bridge where it breaks down, and you can kind of follow the drums where he'll go. Can do down down, or you can go. And that's the only kind of change that's different, is just that. Nothing feels better than being in time. And when you play along to that song and you hit that drum beat and you're going. The whole song. So have fun, work on those chord changes, make sure you get those open strings in between those slides, make it all sound cool, practice slow, and have fun.